Senate mission assigned. Take settlement Manila. Time limit 10 turns. The Senate asks you to take this settlement for the glory of the Empire. Okay, so the Senate is the League of Nations, and yeah, they are them pretty much the League of Nations, the United States of America, the British Empire, the British Commonwealth of Nations, and the Free French, the French Republic, as they are also known. They are the Roman factions of this game. It's based on Rome Total War after all. So the Senate is the League of Nations, and the United States is one of the Empire factions, even though they are not an empire. Okay, and we just got the mission to take Manila from the Japanese here. But we have no fleet to go there right now. Look at the Japanese fleet size. They have three huge fleets. We need a new fleet, of course. So in America, way we have the map visible, so you can see India has these areas, and we have Portugal here with one area, so they hold Vasco da Gama. Otherwise India is holding Bangalore, Hyderabad, Bombay, and Ahmedabad. I believe Ahmedabad is the capital of Pakistan, by the way. Pakistan didn't exist in this time period. I believe India was held by the British Empire, and now they have revolted because they want to free India. And Pakistan and India were once the same country. They split into two different countries because half the country believed in the Indian gods and the other half were Muslims. And instead of having constant problems in faith, they decided to split into two nations, but they were one nation for a short period, and before that they were occupied by Britain. Okay, we have the British, they hold the rest of India, and they hold some areas here too, bordering Thailand. We have Thailand here, we have three areas, surrounded by the Empire of Japan, which has forced them into an alliance. We have America here, holding these isles, Palembang. We have some troops, we have planes here, but very bad tanks, T1 Cunningham tanks. Okay, we have some more troops in Batavia and in Mataram. I've seen in some campaigns America expand all the way up here, and in other campaigns Japan or others have actually taken all of these areas. They can move over the water here all the way to this area, then they get stuck because they can't move anymore. So I gave this area used to belong to America, Hollandia, but I gave it to Japan, so now there will be some fighting between Britain and Japan here. America still is holding this Isle Bonaire, and they have some troops there. We can send them to fight this Isle, but we need a fleet first. So you see that China is held by the People's Republic of China. We have the communists here. I believe this is the Republic of China, Kuomintang, and this is the People's Republic of China, the communists. So the difference is that they have peoples in the front of the name. Okay. So they are the People's Republic, and the others are the Republic. Okay, and then we have Japan. They're holding Manchuria, or Manchukuo in Japanese, and the Manchukuo, and they also hold some areas in China that they've conquered. I believe they invaded China in 1931, and now it's 1942, so of course they've conquered some areas in China by this point. Yeah, the real nation that started World War II was Japan, actually, because they started the war with China already in 1931. Before it even was a world war. But I guess Hitler made it into a world war when he attacked Poland, but Japan started their war already in 1931. So okay, and yeah, they hold Korea and some other areas. We have Soviet here too, holding Siberia and all of the eastern Russian areas. Okay, the British, they are also holding an ire. I believe they hold Singapore here. They have a huge fleet. Japan have another big fleet here. And the British are likely to be attacked. Actually, I think it's time to aid our British friends. We'll station troops next to the British and help them in the defense. And actually, we can send more troops there. How many do we need to get the full army? We need 12 troops. So these are 11. So you can see we can move quite a lot each turn, which is kind of true to the era we are playing. We can move pretty fast with trucks and planes and ships, modern ships. Okay. This area can't move. Okay, we are stuck here. Can't move from Mataram. But I've seen Mataram be invaded. Maybe they used a ship to place them there. Okay. So now this force will face the Japanese together with our ally. They only have infantry here. And a general on a jeep, I believe. Otto Percival. Historical general, the one that gave up. He should have some artillery. I forgot to add that. He didn't have any tanks, though. The British didn't have any tanks in the east. Because they thought that the jungles were... It was impossible to use tanks in the jungles. And the Japanese thought differently, so they have tanks. But fortunately, the Americans have some tanks here. In about the same quality as... Japanese ones, and they have some planes too, corsairs, and we have some assault infantry, grenadiers, riflemen, okay, and a unit of Harley-Davidson XA motorcycles, okay, we'll fight to the death there. Japan is also very likely to attack Balikpapan, our base in the Philippines. We only have riflemen, assault infantry, and anti-tank guns. We also have corsairs, but the anti-tank units are fewer in numbers. They are OP otherwise. They are very good. Okay. So you can expect to fight the Battle of the Philippines soon, which we will lose, no doubt. And you can see Japan is holding areas here. China has most of China. I believe the communists in China will take Beijing and Kalgan if they are lucky, but we'll probably lose them anyway. What about our continent? By the way, we have a port here. We have two ships. Representing the two carriers, but we have no carriers in the game. So we have a Chester ship and a Iowa battle ship. Okay. So we can use these to move troops. I think it's time to move them to some friendly port. Move them to the port of Las Vegas here. Ah, we can't click there. We need to click on the green area. We'll do that. Ah, they got some bonus points too. That's good. Oh, they can move even. Further. That was surprising. They reach this area in one turn. I do not have any cheating on, so the reason that worked is probably because we have the maximum number of distance they can travel on. Okay, so we can see that we are holding all of these areas. So the British Empire holding Montreal, Toronto, and they got Calgary back because I really it was a British area. I thought it was Alaska at first, but no. So I gave it back to the British. So we have 12 areas and the British have 3. Let's check our construction. So Boston, a large city. Okay. What we need is we need ports. We are a seafaring nation after all. We need paved roads too. So we can enhance the movement even further. We'll build ports wherever we can. And roads. So Britain is not likely to attack us anytime soon because they are a Roman faction in the same alliance as us under the Senate, under the League of Nations. But of course they will attack at one point or another. We are playing easy difficulty to prevent them from doing it too soon. And very hard they will do it pretty soon, I believe. But not until 1943 or something. But now they are less likely to do it fast. But we might be wrong, they might do it anyway. You can never trust the Rome to war AI. Yeah, it is very backstabbing, unfortunately. I don't like backstabbing AI. Okay, I like that the enemies are aggressive, but I don't like that the allies are backstabbing. So we'll build roads and ports everywhere. Okay, roads and ports. Every area. Don't want roads if there are ports. So, okay, because we need fleets. Challenge the Japanese. The U-boat fleets of the Germans. We don't want to face them without a fleet of our own. Here we can go for some barracks in Reykjavik. Okay. Oh, we have a known general there. Dwight Eisenhower. Dwight D. Eisenhower. He needs to be moved from there. He's a known general. Then we have a pretty large army there too. Yeah, we have quite a force in Reykjavik, the capital of Iceland. Okay, I think we are done with the constructions and building. So we'll go for the units now. So in Boston, we can go for some ships. Of course, we want ships. We'll go for some really good ships. Go for a New Mexico ship. It takes 3 turns to construct, 4 turns for the Iowa. Actually, I want the Iowa battleship, even if it takes 4 turns. So we'll go for that. And in New York, we can only get troopers and Chester. No, we had Iowa here too, and New Orleans and New Mexico. Let's see here. We have the trooper, the worst trip. Everyone has troopers. Transport ships, and then we have Chester. it's like support vessel, I believe. Better than the troopers. We have New Mexico battleship. And we have the New Orleans, another battleship. I believe New Mexico has better defense, and New Orleans has better attack. Then we have the Ova, it has the best defense and the best attack. Okay, we'll go for it. Need a strong navy. Okay, in Washington, the capital, the United States, we couldn't get any good stuff. It's just a large town for some reason, while New York and Boston is, they are large cities, while Washington is just a town. Okay, might not be historically correct. Okay, let's see here. We'll go for anti-tanks, grenadiers, assault infantry and riflemen. Yeah. In Panama, we can go for a Chester ship. I want my fleet as soon as possible. Jacksonville, we'll go for some Chesters. And in Chicago, we can't go for any ships, so we'll go for something else. guess we go for the. Let's see here. M53, M55 could be good. An anti-aircraft truck is more interesting. Let's go for it first. Then the various artillery units. One unit of Harley Davidson. One M7 Priest. And a bunch of Shermans would be good. We have a lot of money. Okay, let's go for an Iowa battleship in New Orleans. In Dallas, go for Iowa as well. So America is a rich faction. Okay, in Denver, we could go for... also go for spies and diplomats, but we have hardly anyone to speak to. I could go for a diplomat, and I guess we want a spy. We won't play with the map visible after all. We will just have it visible now until we click end turn, because I want to check the rest of the map too. But then we will make it in a fog of war map, and then we need to use the diplomat to get visible. So we can't see what happens in the world unless we speak to factions and move around. Okay, so we'll go for both the diplomat and the spy in Denver. But we'll also go for a grenadier unit, an assault infantry unit, and a rifleman unit. Okay. In Las Vegas we'll go for, let's see here, let's go for a M7 Priest, a M5 Howitzer, Harley Davidson, XA motorcycle, mortar, and some Shermans. And in Los Angeles, we'll go for ships. By the way, I might be able to recruit more than one unit. Let's see here. We'll do that. We'll go back to the first place where we started the construction of a ship, and then we will try to get more. So an Iowa in Seattle as well. On the air we'll go for some Corsairs. And in Matram we'll go for some Riflemen. In Balikpapan we'll go for a Rifleman unit. It will be needed in the coming battle. Batavia will go for Chester. No, actually, we need troops. Let's go for Corsair in Batavia. Corsair unit. Can go for many of them. We need air power. In Palembang, warning the enemy, we will probably go for some troops. Casablanca in Africa, in Morocco, I believe. We will go for some troopers. And in Reykjavik, we will go for some troopers. No, troopers are worse than the others. Let's check again. 36, 1, 28, 16. These are better attack, we'll go for them. Okay, I don't need a trooper. Prefer the Chester over the trooper. Casablanca, by the way, I want a diplomat there. We'll go for the trooper too. I mean the Chester. Okay. We're back in Boston. Let's go for a New Orleans ship and a New Mexico ship as well. And in New York, we'll do the same. And in Washington, we could only get infantry. We'll go for a trooper here too. In Jacksonville, we'll go for a trooper as well. And in New Orleans, we'll of course go for the... let's see here. New Orleans battleship, of course, and the New Mexico. Dallas, we can go for them as well. And in Los Angeles as well. And in Seattle. Now we're almost out of money. Okay, we're done with the recruitment on the first turn. Let's see if we have any agents on the map already. Agents, we have 0 agents at the start. Let's see here. To manage taxes only can be on. We place this in the middle, as I always do. And we check the faction, we can see that capital city is Washington, D.C. Faction leader is Franklin Roosevelt, Franklin D. Roosevelt. Family members is 8, or R8. Regions controlled, 19. Battles won 0, battles lost 0. Victory condition, survivor. Hold 15 provinces and destroy or outlast the following faction or factions: French State Vichy, the Third Reich, Italian Empire, and the Japanese Empire. So it's easy to hold 15 regions. We are already doing that. We are holding 19 currently. But we need to destroy the French State Vichy. Probably the Reich will do that for us. So that won't be a problem, I believe. But the Reich itself could be a problem unless the Soviets will defeat them. The Italian Empire, they most likely will be taken care of by the Reich, but I'm not sure. Okay, the Japanese Empire is also a problem. We will have to attack their mainland for that, because even if they lose in Asia, which happens sometimes, they have been nerfed. Previously they would always win in Asia, and Germany would always win in Europe, but now they can be defeated. But Japan, unlike Germany, has a lot of Isles, actually. And with those islands, I believe that they will never be defeated unless a player goes to those islands with an army. So we need to attack mainland Japan to take them out of the game. Okay, otherwise we won't win. Okay, Germany in Africa will probably be handled by the British and the French and such. We could probably help, but we will, I think, focus on the Vichy French. Okay, and we have a fleet here. 2 ships, but they are pretty good. New Orleans and New Mexico. Let's move them into the port here. Our enemies have more fleets, stronger fleets. We have the French State Vichy with a great fleet here under Admiral Franquis, and they are an enemy. And then we have the Italian fleet. They have 3. Then we have the German U-boat fleet here too. So our fleet is at a great disadvantage. We needed some ships here just to land the troops in Casablanca, taken by the Vichy French. Oh, okay, taken from the Vichy French, I mean. Not by them, but from them. Okay, so we are ready. Let's toggle FAO. As usual, the first episode in a Let's Play will always be longer. So that's why I spent a lot of time in the faction selection screen and in the main menu and such. So we have removed the Fog of War, the FOE, and we are ready to move. Here we have George Patton. We can move out this army into George Patton's army. Here we have a city, by the way. So all the areas on the map are German cities, German custom cities, because we had no others and I didn't want any vanilla cities. So in the 2.01 version, we have French cities and Italian cities and even one African city and I believe one Japanese town. If I had them in the game, I would have used the French cities for all the allies except the Soviet Union, and then I would have used the Italian cities for the Soviet Union because they have a similar culture to Italy, and then I would have used it for Italy and Romania as well. and then the rest would have been the Germans, except some African regions and Turkey. They would have used the African city, and then I believe the Japanese town would have been used for everyone in Asia. Okay, but in this version, unfortunately, we only have the German stuff, because I don't know how to port a custom settlement from one version to another. In Medieval 2, I would have been able to do it, because it's easy, because you have a tool, and it's easy to use, but in this version, in Rome to the War, seems to be a lot of files involved, and I don't know the process. So, otherwise, I would have wanted the French cities. They even have Paris itself, and Berlin itself. It's not here. We have the German town, the German large town, the German city, and the German large city, but we do not have Berlin itself. So if you fight in Berlin, you fight in the large city. And if you fight in Washington, no, in New York, for example, or Boston, you fight in the German large city too. So that's a frame that we don't have Berlin and Paris and such, but that's how it is. It's, at least we don't have any antiquity buildings or villages or towns or whatever. Okay, so we can attack the free French. And my idea is that we will send forth the army against Marrakesh, and we can most likely fuck, it didn't work, I fucked up, so I need to I had a mortar there. I should have had a mortar in the same army as fuck, I should have had a mortar same army as George Patton. If I started with this army now, then I'm sure that the enemy will then Patton will die in the battle. I don't want that, and I don't want to wait either. Fuck, and I don't want to restart it. Because then I need to do the building construction and stuff. I should have saved. Okay, but we will wait then one turn. They will probably sally out or something. We have no choice but to wait there. I fucked up first movements there. So we have no other armies here. We have some allies here. They are visible because they are part of the Roman factions in the game. In the code, we can see the other Romans on the map. The British and the Free French. Okay, and the League of Nations. By the way, I forgot that we haven't checked the map. So, in Latin America, you can see that Mexico is held by the League of Nations, as I said, the Senate. Then we also hold Panama here, the army. And then the League of Nations is holding Bogota, capital of Colombia as well. And then we move down to South America. You see that Sao Paulo is held by Portugal, representing the Portuguese-speaking peoples there. And Argentina is held by the Reich, because they were Nazi sympathizers and didn't declare war until like 1 month before Hitler died, and only broke their relations in 1944. Can be compared with Chile here, breaking the relations in 1942. So they are Spain. So we have some new contenders in South America. So we need to attack Japan and attack the Vichy and Germans, but we also need to make sure that the Germans do not come from here, and that the Chileans here, they don't conquer the area. And also Portugal, Brazil here might attack us. It's not certain that they will stay neutral. Okay, and Africa, as we can see, Northern Africa is held by the Vichy French, our enemy. And then we have the Free French, the blue area on the map. And we have some Portuguese areas, Luanda and Beira. And then we have another Vichy French area there. Then we have some red areas, the British Empire holding South Africa and Egypt and such. And then we have the Italian areas, Mogadishu and Addis Ababa, and they also hold Tripoli. capital of Lebanon. Okay, and then we have the British here in the Middle East, they hold Jerusalem. The Vichy French holding Damascus, capital of Syria. The British are holding Baghdad, capital of Iraq. So they've already defeated the nationalists in Iraq. There were a revolution there by nationalists who supported the Axis, but they were invaded by the British and the Soviets, I believe. The British and the French, actually. And this takes place after that invasion. The French, the Free French, they are holding Aleppo still. Okay, we have Turkey. In mainland Turkey, we have Germany holding Athens, Italy holding Tirana, capital of Albania. And then we have the Bulgarians, their capital Sofia. Istanbul is of course held by Turkey. Italy is holding mainland Italy. We have Spain. In Spain we have Lisbon, the capital of Portugal, is held by Portugal of course. And Germany is holding France and the lower countries, the Netherlands and Belgium. Britain is holding mainland Britain. Ireland isn't really on the map. I believe half of Ireland were Nazi sympathizers because they supported the enemy of Britain. Okay, and then we have Hungary, Romania, and the German Reich has taken Poland, has taken the Baltic states and freed them, liberated them from the Soviet Union. They saw that as a liberation. They liked the Nazis more than the Soviets because the Nazis weren't as bad to the Baltic people as the Soviets were, even though the Nazis were worse to other people, but to the Baltics they were better. Okay, and then Soviet Union have this huge stretch of land armies here, but they can't move, they are more like a wall now. We have Germany taking Stalino here. Italy is holding Cargo, they have an army outside too. Hungary is holding Kursk. And then Germany has taken Smolensk too. Leningrad is still held by Soviet Union. We have Finland, they are holding Petrozavodsk, taken from the Soviets. They also have their capital. We have Romania, haven't really expanded, but they are likely to take Sevastopol. Okay. And that's the map, I believe. The Vichy friends hold an eye over here too. And that's the map. Okay, let's remove toggle foul. And I did a mistake in Africa, so we can't play that battle. We will probably have to fight it in defense. They will probably sally out. The AI in Room to War usually do that when we besiege. Actually, it might stop the siege then, to prevent them from doing that. Okay, so no attack there. We have no more armies in Africa or the Middle East or nor in Europe. So we have to count on Soviet Union to handle the Germans for now in Europe, and we will probably have to kill off the League of Nations at one point or another, but as long as they haven't betrayed us, we won't do it. We can also probably force them into a vassal status. We'll probably do that first, but I've seen that if you ally someone, they will still betray you. But if you have them as a vassal, they will never betray you unless they are stronger than you. Because I tried playing as the League of Nations and made a vassal of America as soon as they attacked me, but because I didn't want to fight the entirety of the USA as this little faction, but they betrayed me immediately, even as a vassal or protectorate. So if the protectorate or vassal is too strong, then they won't accept you as their overlord. But if you are stronger, if you play as Germany, for example, and make a vassal out of Hungary, then they will stay loyal to you. But if you attack If you make an ally of Hungary instead, they are likely to stab you in the back, even if you are a strong faction like Germany. If you make a vassal out of Germany when you play as Finland, for example, then they are likely to betray you, because they feel that they are stronger than you, so they shouldn't be your vassal. Okay, so that's why it's very, very hard to survive in this game. It's a small faction. That's why I'm playing as the United States. Otherwise, I could have wanted to play as Finland, maybe, but they will get attacked by too many at once. I believe if you play as Finland, both the Reich and Soviet will attack you. Okay. But anyway, so we are building up our forces. And we do not have any ships in these areas. I would like to aid the British over there. So we didn't need to move both the ships to this port here. Now they have already moved. Let's move the Chester down here. So we can move this army. I can't click like this, like in medieval 2. I need to click on the green area. Okay. Anyway, we might be able to build a ship or something before they even reach that area. I don't know. Problem with the Iowa is that they take forever to be built. 4 turns. We have an army here, but we don't want to fight alone against Japan. We want the British to back us up. Unfortunately, the British do not have any good troops. They have Indian volunteer assault infantry. Well, it's good infantry. Riflemen, basic infantry, and Australian riflemen. Okay. So the Australian riflemen have better stats than the others, but they are still basic troops. Okay, let's end the turn. So we are attacked. George Patton is attacked by 1501 Vichy French troops, backed up by Captain Figaro with 121 additional troops. So Captain Aylart with 1501 men. So they have 1, 2, 3, 4. So they have 6 riflemen. They have 2 units of Dewitin fighter planes. Pretty good unit. And they have 1 unit of Renault FT tanks, the worst possible tank, probably the only one worse is the Fiat 3000, the Italian tank. Okay, they have 2 anti-aircraft trucks, and 1 unit of assault infantry, and 1 unit of scout snipers. Okay, then they had 151 additional troops. So we are backed up by 1 army, we'll let it be controlled by the AI. Save the game in case it's CTD. We'll name it USA1 and we will so allow this army to be controlled by the AI. Yes. And we will fight this battle. I want a battle in every episode. So this episode became very, very longer than I wanted it to. I wanted it be 1 hour. It's probably been 2 hours now. Alright, so we'll fight this battle and check the new turn and do our moves and such, and then at the start of the next battle we will end it. If there is a battle immediately after this one, we will end it there. Okay. Start deployment. I believe they will attack me in the Philippines too. And maybe in Singapore. Start deployment. Problem with loading saves in this game, by the way, is that every time you load a save game, all your damaged bikes, cars, trucks, and tanks will lose their riders or turrets. The only way to fix this is by merging the tanks and the trucks and the bikes, etc. So you click on all the trucks and then you click on the M button to merge them. You click on your arm and then you click on the M button and then you merge them. An alternative way is to drag them, so you click on a bike and then you drag it over the other bike unit that is lacking units, and then you refill the numbers. But you need the fully sized numbers for the turrets and the riders to be visible, otherwise they will fight without the riders, and that's really ugly. Unfortunately, with the AI, you are likely to face some of those armies without turrets, unfortunately, when they are damaged after a reload of the game. So as long as you play this first turn, if you play without exiting game, they will look fine. But if you exit the game and load a saved game, then they won't look fine. If you merge your troops, your units will look fine again. But the enemy units won't look fine unless the AI is merging them. You can't really control the AI, so you might see some old tanks and such without turrets until they recruit new troops during your current playthrough. But then when you exit again, the same issue will happen, unfortunately. Okay, so we are starting here. I think I have moved them back. Okay, let's start the battle. Reinforcements, Captain Jack. Reinforcements have arrived. A welcome additional bulwark of might and bravery. Yeah, let's lose formation on the general. Our allies' army is over here. So we had some planes. We had the grenadiers there. We have some corsairs. We have the T1 Cunningham light tanks, only ever used in prototype. They were never used in battle, they were only ever in prototype. But they were added in this game, like as a what if they were used. So they are about the same as the Fiat 3000s and the renowned FTs. They are probably better than the Fiat 3000s Italian tanks, but worse than the renowned, or same. Might be better. Actually, we can check this one. So they're in out FT tank, 12 melee attack, 12 missile attack, and 35 total defense. Special attack, frighten nearby enemy, excellent morale, can't hide, fast moving. The Renault FT was a French light tank that was among the most revolutionary and influential tank designs in history. The FT was the first produced tank to have its armament within a fully rotating turret. The Renault FT's configuration, crew compartment at the front, engine compartment at the back, and the standard tank layout as such. The Renault FT's configuration, crew compartment at the front, engine compartment at the back, and main armament in a revolving turret became and remains the standard tank layout. As such, some historians of armored warfare have called the Renault FT the world's first modern tank. Yeah, but it's from the 20s, so that's why it's not that good. Over 2,000 Renault FT tanks were manufactured by French industry. Most of them during 1918. Another 950 of an almost identical licensed copy of the FT, the M1917 light tank, were made in the United States, but not in the time to enter combat. Okay. And what about the T1 Cunningham? They have 15 melee and 15 missiles, so they are better. They have 3 more attack and same defense, 35. Special attack, frighten nearby enemy, excellent morale, can't hide, very fast moving. Introduced in 1927, it was developed up through 1932 as a series of modified versions. Most versions of the T1 series of light tanks share the same basic layout, with the engine mounted in front and the turret, transmission and the final drive all located in the rear. Okay, so this one is better. It's from 1927, and the other one is from 1918. Okay, the French tank is really outdated. We have large size on. They are more numerous than in all huge, as I said. I didn't want to use huge because it was impossible to move troops in cities. this is pretty good. Of course, when the army is reinforcing, I didn't want it to be controlled by me. Prefer just letting the AI handle it. Need to keep an eye on path and see if you won't die. If they somehow attack him during the battle. There are quite a few planes, just one unit or two. Here we have some assault infantry of the United States. Riflemen. Have their Harley Davidson motorbikes inspired by the German BMW motorcycles. But unlike the Germans, the Americans didn't think they worked very well in battle. They replaced them or didn't use them much. Germany used a lot of bikes in their campaign. The Baltic and elsewhere in Russia. The bikes only have machine guns, so that's kind of weak against panzers and such. It's more effective to have Shermans. Okay, Sherman tanks. Enemy general fallen, Captain Allard of the French take Vichy. This is a very even battle. 17% allies killed, 48% enemies killed. Our planes should be better than theirs. Our tanks are better, as you saw. Both of the tanks have the small shell, though. Planes are similar. Just the American planes are better than the French. I believe the French are the worst ones in the game. Minor factions are using the same as other as the main factions. Yeah, they borrow from the major factions. With some exceptions, I believe Romania and Bulgaria have some unique planes. Maybe Italy too. But Italy is like a main power, just a weaker one. Okay. American infantry sailing fort. Oh, they have some anti-air aircraft trucks. Got one of them there. So I'm currently playtesting if it's worth it to keep the current unit sizes on large. Or if we should reduce the numbers. It depends on how much it will CTD or crash the desktop. I believe battles on the field are fine, but the city battles, it might be too much. When you combine the unit numbers with the custom settlements, it might be too much for the engine to handle. It might crash in the late battle. When you have killed almost all the enemies, then it CTD all of a sudden. You need to replay it, which is annoying. Seems we have the air superiority in this battle. We still have some planes in the air, though. It's not entirely won. The air battle is still going on. They might have more planes than we had. We might have the numerical advantage in the air. We should have the quality advantage. Oh, they took down one. Might be wrong. Let's pause the game. I want to know the stats of the planes. I just need to find a shadow. To click on the planes, you need to click on the shadow. So we have the Corsair here. Special abilities at glance. Special attack, bonus vs planes and vehicles. Can swim, long range missiles, right nearby enemy. Excellent morale, can't hide. Melee attack 3, missile attack 10-6, only the missile counts. They have 24 in total defense and 26 in attack. Okay. What about the French? That's not a French plane. need to find the French. Because we click on their little black dots here, the shadows. They were 18, or they were 18. Okay, so they have 26 missile attack, same as us. 26 in defense. Fortunately, I'm kind of stupid and forget numbers pretty fast, so we need to click on the Corsair. I believe they have the same attack, though. But the Corsairs have less defense, so they have worse planes than the French. Then the Corsairs are the worst, unfortunately. Maybe the Japanese have worse planes, I don't know. But the Corsairs are worse than the French planes. We will lose this battle because of that. It's time to retreat with Patton. Catastrophe of a battle. Because their planes have better defense. Which isn't correct, I believe. I believe the American plane should be better. But anyway, we saved our general. Because without air superiority, I believe our infantry won't win the fight. We are already fleeing grenadiers and the riflemen. Here we have a unit that isn't retreating currently, an assault infantry unit. But yeah, the battle seems to be lost. Because of their air force, their air power. So we underestimated the French air force. Okay. They still have some tanks too. Some Renault FT tanks. That sucks that we don't have better planes than the French. That means we have the worst fighters. Or probably the worst fighters. I'm not sure. The Japanese might have even worse. I don't know. If we have a really good bomber, the Boeing 17. Boeing B-17. Yeah, they are taking us out from the sky. So we need to build up our forces in America and then just invade with huge numbers. Here we have a Harley Davidson motorbike. Still running over the troops. It's winded. Ah, but that sucked.
Our ally lies dead, slain by the enemy. We must help his men avenge him.
That unit was broken. Yeah, the French were stronger than expected. The Vichy French. The French state. Vichy. Even their sucky Renault FT tanks moving forward, winning the battle.
Of fate that
snatched
victory from our group.
Fuck. Oh yeah, so Patton killed 5 and our army under Captain Jack killed 982. They killed fewer. Captain Allard of the United of the Vichy French killed 787. And Captain George killed 48, okay. And the details, battle statistics. Of the Battle of Morocco, 1942. George Patton versus Captain Jack. Okay. That's impossible. The Americans only know how to make razor blades, Reich Marshal Hermann Göring. Yeah, the Americans weren't known for their military strength. back in the 30s and 40s. Okay. We are attacked at Balikpap on to the Philippines, where Captain Ralph will face off against Isoroku Yamamoto himself. He has an army, including Zeros. 28 missile better attack than the French and American planes. Defense 23, Oblivia 24. Defense, let's see here. Can't click on our plane here. But I believe we have one better defense, but they have better attack. Okay. They also have Renault Utsu, a modified Renault FT tank. developed by Japan from 1925 through 1928. So it's clearly better than the old Renault FT, an improved version, but it's still about the same as the T1 Cunningham. Okay, they have two of them, and then they have a unit of Type 96 artillery. And some grenadiers, riflemen, and mortar. Okay, and they have a general with his jeep, or a car in this. Yeah, it's kind of a car instead of a jeep. Okay, we can save here. We will create the second save. And actually I won't exit the game, because as I said, then the units will become messed up probably. At least cars, tanks, jeeps, etc. and trucks, bikes, but and I don't want the Japanese to look bugged. We will fight this battle after I have gone and eaten, but for now we will end the episode here. I will continue immediately after I have eaten, so Episode 2 will start soon. Okay, thank you for watching. See you.